It's still only day three of the second test match. We're on Cricketry, and mind you, we're talking about the game being over. Well, it should have been over today had the Sri Lankans got their act together with their bowling. Well, if there weren't no balls, if those catches were taken, who knows, the extra half hour could have been taken. But South Africa, 139 for 5, they still got 351 runs more. It's more like surviving 2 days, and it is absolutely difficult. Now, I can tell you that the South Africans are in serious trouble here. Sri Lanka made batting look easy on this surface, and that had a lot to do with the way they batted on this surface. Maharaj was tired, he was bowling, and he had bowled a lot. It was a marathon effort. He's bowled more than 80 overs in both innings. But it was the way the Sri Lankans approached their innings. It was a quiet start. They didn't want to do things differently. Dimuth Karunaratne looked to pile on the agony. Unfortunate to miss that 100, but Matthews and Roshan Silva just continued. It was good. Good to see them batting the way they should, using the sweep shot, running the single, coming down the pitch. Now, that's the way you would expect batsmen to play spin on the surface. Now, that's exactly what the South Africans did not do. Now, when South Africa started, we did see that they were adopting a new method. They were looking to play the reverse sweep, one or two conventional sweeps too. But what Sri Lanka didn't do correctly was getting their act together in terms of discipline. Now, Dilruwan Pereira, I wonder, celebrating his 36th birthday, what excuse he could ever give for overstepping. As a spinner, I don't and I can't understand him overstepping. Now, he should have had Elgar twice, and Elgar got reprieves and finally LBW. Now, the rest of the Sri Lankan spinners, I thought, was outstanding. Akhila Dhananjaya's mystery, the variety, is something that the South African batsmen seem to struggle with. But look at the way De Bruyne batted. He made batting look very simple. He was either right forward or right back. There was nothing in between. And he also used the sweep shot well. So I get the feeling that it has a lot to do with the South African approach and the South African mentality. But having said that, well done to Sri Lanka. I think they're running all over South Africa. And a lot to do with the South African mentality and their approach. And it's not always that a number 7 team beats number 2. And I believe that will happen tomorrow.